If you can see my screen, so it's a shared screen. So before starting with this particular data science training, so let just give me some introduction about myself. So this is me, the Vamsi Krishna Guttula. So I'm having around some 15 years of experience, so both in the trainings, developments, and delivering support. So all the complete industry training we are having. So, and my experience basically includes some managing, processing, and analysis of large volumes of business data. So I worked as a database programmer, a BI developer, a big data architect, and a big data technologist, and the data science technologist. So this is about myself. So today in our introduction class, the points to be gets discussed here is, what is data science? Who is a data scientist? So who can be a data scientist? What are the technologies a modern data scientist is required? And what are the industries in the data science data workflow will be there, and the industry usage of the data science, and what are the technologies used in the data science. So anyhow, this is a presentation. So without the presentation also, I'll give you some points to be gets discussed. First of all, exactly a data science. A data science is nothing but, it's a one of the part of the computer science engineering, where we are going to completely works with the data itself. We are going to completely works with the data itself. So everything, anything that is to work with the particular data is nothing but what we are going to call it as a one of the part of the computer science engineering that is called as a data science. So what are the things that we can do with the data? It's not like a database, just like storing the data and just manipulating the data. It's not like a retrieval and a manipulation of the data. A data scientist has to know a various techniques to work with this particular data, which includes something like handling the data. So handling the data means something nothing but storage of the particular data. How to store the data? As you know that you can store the data in a format of databases, but as you know that database store the data in the format of structured format. But as part of the current scenario, the real world data is going to be getting generated in different formats, like it may be a structured data, or it may be some unstructured data, or it may be some semi-structured data. So how to handle that kinds of data? And apart from that, as you know that day by day, the data size is also getting increasing. So beyond the imaginary, so completely, it is completely an imaginary data. So the data has started increasing into some terabytes of the data. After terabytes, it may be some petabytes of the data. And now the data sizes has been increased up to almost all some zettabytes of the data. Our database systems can handle the data only up to some terabytes of the data. Beyond that, they cannot store the particular data. So how to handle that kind of large volumes of data, and how to handle that kind of unstructured and semi-structured data? So for that, we are going to take some help of some big data technologies. So why the big data has came into the picture? Why the real world is using the big data? Basically, to store any volume of data it can be get stored, or even it can store any variety of the data. Like it can store any structured or unstructured, semi-structured, any kind of the data it's going to be. So in a data science project, your work is going to start from handling the data. That is nothing but storing some huge volumes of data, and any variety of the data can be get stored. After storing the data, the next thing is going to be here is, as you know that whenever I capture the data from the real world, the data may not be in a proper structured format and may not be in a consistent format. So for that, what we have to do? We have to perform something called as a data cleansing has to be gets performed. The next technique which we are going to learn is, as we have to use is the data cleansing technique. So what do you mean to say data cleansing? Data cleansing is nothing but some methods and some technologies which we use to cleanse the data, to identify the inaccurate data, and to identify some inconsistent data and replacing with a consistent and accurate data. For example, let us say that whenever I collect some data from a social media, for example, some for analysis, I collected some social media data, like for something like a Facebook or from a Twitter, I have collected the data. So whenever I look at the date of birth of the particular people, there is no guarantee that your data will be an accurate data. Why? Because some people are going to give some wrong date of birth also. So whenever I collected some information about the data, I may find some people who are having an age more than even 120 years of the age is also going to be gets available. But practically, it is not possible to have a person who is going to be having more than 120 years of going to be. So this is not an accurate data. It is an inconsistent data. So we have to identify that particular inconsistent data. But how can I identify? That means what is an accurate data? I have to replace it. So I cannot call the person. I cannot ask him what is exactly date of birth. So I can collect some information. So who are his friends? I can collect the information. What are the ages of the friends? What are their average ages? Generally, whenever his friend's age is around some 21 years of average age, automatically his age is also going to be approximately with the same year of the 21 years of age. So this technique is nothing but what we are going to call it as the data cleansing technique we are going to call it as. So before going for the analytic part, first of all, we have to do some data cleansing. Without having a proper cleansing of data, if I do some analytics part on the data, which we cannot understand, which we cannot proper do a proper analysis on that. So handling a large volumes of data and data cleansing. The next important is going to be what we are going to call it as data analytics. So that is a main important part of a particular a data scientist or a data science projects, data analytics. It is nothing but one kind of understanding the data, more and more in deep about the data. We do a lot of statistical analysis. We are going to use some lot of statistical formulas like mean, mode, medians. We are going to use something like a standard deviation, variance, quantiles. These are all the different kind of statistical analysis. So data analytics is nothing but something we are trying to understand the data, trying to analyze the data. So trying to find out the common patterns. So what are the particular patterns the people are following? You can identify such kind of analytics with this particular data analytics part. After the data analytics, we have to perform something called as the data visualization. As you know that what is the main visualization? So whenever we look at the data, the hidden patterns, the hidden information, it cannot be normally seen with the values. So we have to visualize the data. As you know that visualization is a better method of the storytelling, which we call it as a storytelling skills. So whenever you want to go for a data visualization, so we are expressing our understanding. Whatever the understanding we have done, that we are going to give it in a visual format, we are going to give it. That is what we are going to call it as data visualization. And the main important in our course curriculum, that is going to be the one of the main important concept, that is machine learning concept. So if you can observe carefully, in a data science project, you will be having a various techniques. It is not a various tools we can call it as. We are going to call it as a different technologies which we are going to use, a different methods we are going to use it. Anyhow, I'll make you understand what is a machine learning later. So from handling the data, data cleansing, data analytics, data visualization, and the machine learning. These are the things that we are going to work as part of our data science course curriculum. So what is exactly a data science? A data science is nothing but, as I told you, it is also one of the area of the computer science engineering. One of the interdisciplinary area in the computer science engineering, where I'm going to use various methods, various techniques, various scientific systems. And the end purpose of using this data science is getting some knowledge or getting some insights from the data. Whether the data may be a structured data or it may be an unstructured data. And this data science is something similar to, almost all similar to the data mining itself. It is almost all similar to the data mining itself. So data mining and machine learning is likely a little bit different, similar part only. But data mining is do some prediction, not depending on the scientific, it is not depending on the statistical modeling. It is going to be depends on the business modeling it is going to be. Whereas our data science is going to do the prediction based on the statistical model. So what is exactly a data science? The same point, whatever I have told, whatever explain you in a presentation, if you can see, what is a data science actually? So data science is nothing but, it is also called as a data-driven science. It is one of the interdisciplinary field about some scientific methods, the same I told you, the scientific methods, process, and some systems, and to extract some knowledge and insights from the data, which is available in the various forms. Either it may be a structured or it may be an unstructured. It is similar to the data mining. It is something about some scientific methods. It's not about some softwares, some scientific methods, process, and some systems to extract some knowledge or some insights from the data. Whether the data may be in a structured or unstructured format and is something similar to the data mining. So that is the same point what we have been discussed about the data science. Then the next point to be discussed is, who is a data scientist? Simple to understand, actually a data scientist is nothing but a person who is good at the statistics. But generally the people who works on statistics, generally we are going to call him as a statistician. Generally the people who are works on the statistics, generally those people are going to be calling them as a statisticians. So generally the statisticians are not that much good at the IT skills. Generally what the statisticians will do is, they will do the statistical analysis by implementing some manual methods. And most of the data scientists, they are going to use the tool as an Excel as the tool itself. Excel is also one of the very powerful tool. Actually as an IT peoples, we generally not aware about that much what is the powerful of Excel. But most of the people who, some people managers and some senior managers are going to be working on the Excel itself. Excel is a very powerful presentation tool. You can do up to some analytics by using the Excel itself. But as you know that in Excel, we cannot use any such kind of much in-deep analytics, and the machine learning cannot be gets done with the help of the Excel sheets. So statisticians mostly depend on the Excel. I have seen a lot of statisticians who completely depends on the Excel sheets itself. They don't use any programming languages. But we have a lot of such kind of programming languages like something like an R and the Python. These are the most powerful statistical analysis tools. So whenever it comes to the programming languages, R is one of the language. Python is also one of the language where we can do a lot of statistical analysis. But being the statisticians are not that much IT skilled people. What we are going to do is, we are coming in the reverse engineering. That means to the IT people, we are going to add some statistics. We are going to add some statistics people. So that particular people are, we are going to be promoting as data scientists. Actually, we cannot call ourselves as a data scientist after this particular course curriculum. We cannot call ourselves as a data scientist. We are going to be called as a machine learning engineer. We are going to be called as the machine learning engineers. Even our job portals like Naukri, Monster, if you see, they says that it is machine learning engineers. Data scientists are completely different. To find a real data scientist, it's a very hard actually. I'll tell you who is exactly a real data scientist and when can we call ourselves as a real data scientist. So what exactly, who exactly a data scientist is nothing but a person, a statistician, who is having a little bit knowledge about the IT skills, or an IT person who is having a little bit knowledge about the statistics. Those people are, we are going to call them as the data scientist, or what we call it as the machine learning engineers. So who is exactly a data scientist is, just to understand this particular concept. So what is the point I'm going to tell you here is, a statistician who is going to be a little bit good at the IT, that's the computer skills, and a person who is an IT, who is going to be a software engineer, who is good at the statistics. So that people we are going to call him as a data scientist. So a person who is better at statistics than any other software engineer and better at the software engineering than any other statistician. So these people we are going to call ourselves, call them as the data scientist, but it's really hard to find a real data scientist actually. So exactly who is a data scientist exactly? Who can be a data scientist? Totally, if you see the next presentation, you can understand a clear understanding about who can be a data scientist. A real data scientist should be having an expertise in three different areas. One is going to be math and statistical knowledge, where he is going to use the various statistical analysis, a various type of learning methods like supervised, unsupervised learnings, some computer skills like some programming languages like R, Python, SQL, NoSQL, it may be any computer, and some domain expertise. He should be a little bit having some knowledge about the domain expertise. But it's really hard to find a real data scientist as part of the current situation. But in a couple of years, so we can find a lot of real data scientists in the real world. So a domain expertise, a knowledge expertise in the math and statistical and knowledge, and apart from that, some a little bit expertise in the computer skills. So this kind of combination of the skills is what we are going to call them as the data scientist. So this is a picture where we can understand a completely a real modern data scientist. As already have discussed about that, a real data scientist has to be having some expertise in the math and statistics, like he should be using some statistical modeling, and he is going to use a various types of learnings like supervised and unsupervised learnings we are going to work, and the machine learning. All these are going to be the part of the maths and the statistics. And programming database knowledge, like whether they works in the SQL or NoSQL databases, and scripting languages like Python, statistical computing packages like R, these are going to be all going to be comes under the programming databases. Even something like a big data systems like Hadoop, and something like a MapReduce concepts, a little bit idea about how to program and how to manage the data. And apart from the data visualization, that is what we call it as storytelling skills, maybe a different type of with data visualization tools, like we have a Tableau, even R and the Python is also one of the most popular and very powerful the data visualization tools. So most of the people may not be seeing this particular R. Most of the people works on Python, but R is a very one of the most popular tool. So where we are going to be get training completely by using the R itself. And apart from that, some domain knowledge is also going to be gets required. So as you can see here, the data scientist, the sexiest job of the 21st century, requires a mixture of some multidisciplinary skills, ranging from an intersection of mathematics, statistics, some computer science, communication, and some business rules also, domain expertise. Finding a real data scientist is very hard, and these are the technologies what a real data scientist is going to be gets required. So this is exactly a real modern data scientist is required. But as we are discussing, it's a very little bit hard to find out. You can find out. For example, you can go to the job portals. Like, just let me show you. I'm going to a job portal like a Naukri. You can just go to the Naukri portals and just you try to type it something like a machine learning engineer. Don't say data scientist, say machine learning engineers. It is going to be our skill set is going to be machine learning engineers. You can find out a lot of jobs based on the machine learning engineering. You can see that. And find the jobs even with an experience of 1 to 2 years of experience. Machine learning, artificial intelligence, web crawling, model validations. You can see Hadoop, R, machine learning, Python. R and the Python is the common languages which most of the machine learning jobs are going to be gets required. Even we can call ourselves as a data scientist, but there is a lot of difference between data scientist and a machine learning engineers. I'll tell you exactly the difference in the coming classes. So if you can see, Python is a common language, artificial intelligence, NLTK, machine learning. So the machine learning is the one of the important concept which we have to be a data scientist or a machine learning engineer should be there. We'll work on that application. So if you can see here, even we can find the jobs even on the data scientist also. But even if I say data scientist also, you are going to find the similar jobs only. You can say data scientist. Even the same jobs is going to be gets coming, like the machine engineers also going to be gets coming. A data scientist, either by using R and the Python. So if you can see, these are the people. Even the Tech Mahindra requires a lot of data scientists right now. In Bangalore, we have a lot of requirements. SQL, statistical modeling, machine learning, by using R and the Python. These are the common languages what we can see here. Data scientist, so R, Python, machine learning. So anywhere you can see, these are the common languages what most of the people are going to be. So data scientist you can see. So these are all the different algorithms actually. KNN, Navibase, SPMs, decision trees, random forest, R, Vika, NumPy. These are all the different packages and the algorithms what we are going to use it here. Anyhow, I again come back to that applications later. So let us come to our discussion point of view. So as I'm saying that a real data scientist is going to be required, so an expert in type of areas like maths, the maths and statistics, and you should be having the knowledge about the programming and databases. And apart from that, you should be having some communication skills, data visualization, and the domain expertise has to be gets required. So how the data science projects are really implemented in real time? This is the data science process. Your raw data, as already told you, storing the data, cleansing the data, doing some analytics part, and apart from the data visualization and machine learning, these are the basic important things. So the raw data is going to be collected from the real world. Data has to be gets processed and the data has to be gets cleaned. And after cleansing the data, we are going to give the data for the exploratory analysis. That is nothing but data analytics part. If proper analytics cannot be gets done, again, it is going to be given for the reprocessing of the data and again cleans the data further and again give it for the exploratory analysis. Based on the analysis we have been got done, we are going to develop the models and algorithms, the predictive models. So it requires at least two sessions to get a complete idea about the data science. So what is exactly the machine learning? So we discuss in the next sessions. So today we are going to discuss about overall about what exactly data science contains. But to get a real picture of a machine learning, a couple of sessions are going to be gets required. And what are the different models and algorithms? After developing the models and algorithms, we are going to communicate to the end users by the visual reports. Based on the visual reports, the end users can take the decisions. Or otherwise, the model can be given as a product in the real time, where it can be used for the predictive analysis. And the data product will be given to the real world, where again the data will be got starts generating. Again, we can start collecting the data. And again, it is a cyclic process. So this data analytics is not a never-ending process actually. It's don't think the product is developed and once it was delivered with that, the work is over. We have to develop the predictive model. The predictive model is going to do the prediction. How effectively it is doing the prediction in the future. So we have to evaluate the performance of that. It is a cyclic process like this. Some raw data will be collected, data will be processed, clean the data set, do some exploratory analysis, develop the models and algorithms, visualize the data, and it is going to be delivered as a data product to the real world. It is a little bit cyclic process, we can see that. And whenever we see a real data science process, if we can see the next presentation, this is the data science workflow. It is a cyclic process, you can see that. First, we have to understand what is our problem first of all. So what the client is expecting. So what the problem has to be get solved. So to solve the problem, to define the problem definition, some domain expertise is going to be required. So separation of some concerns, prioritize each and every problem. We have some 10 problems to be get solved. So what is the prioritize of each and every problem? Collect the data and prepare the data. There will be 5 steps will be there in our data science workflow. Define the problem, data collect and prepare the data, develop the model, deployment the model, and improve the performance. Even when you do it practically also, you are going to have the same 5 steps will be available. First, collect the data, then prepare the data, train the model, evaluate the performance, and improve the model performance. These are the 5 steps which a machine learning algorithm is going to be gets contained. By data collecting and the data preparation, it is nothing but some kind of cleansing the data. So selecting of the right data, data transformation, how to replace the missing values, and exploratory analysis, data analytics part. After that, we have to give it to the machine. Choosing the right algorithm, testing the accuracy of the algorithm, how it is predicting with the other algorithms also, and validate the algorithms. And after that, that will be deployed as an APIs to the end users, as a code which can be accessible from C sharp, Java, or any languages we can access it. This model will be gets converted into an API. We are going to use some different tools are there. We are going to use something like a Flask, etc. There are some tools are available where we are going to use this deployment of the APIs of the whatever the data modeling we are going to do that. And we are going to release as a product to the real time. It is going to do the prediction. Basically, our main idea of the data science is the developing of a predictive model, which I'll tell you more clearly in the whenever we talk about the machine learning concepts. So monitoring the performance of the deployment models, retraining of the model, redeployment of the model, and remonitoring. It's like a cyclic process. Your data science workflow is going to be. So this is the real use cases. So anywhere, almost nowadays, the data science is everywhere. So earlier, it used to be in the life sciences, healthcare and the life sciences, where we can do the prediction. As you know that in life sciences, how important is the prediction. In the coming next 1 year, whether a person is going to be affected with an heart attack or not, if we can predict it 1 year before itself. So it is going to be cost A, life of a particular person. So health and life sciences, and most important is the financial services. So whenever the financial services, they are going to recommend what kind of financial, different kinds of what kind of investment plans to the customers. In retail marketing, we can see, in manufacturing, the best examples are going to be something like your airlines. Dynamic pricing in the airlines is going to be done by this particular machine learning algorithms only. So almost all in every real business scenarios, starting sciences, manufacturing, retail, energy, travel and hospitality, almost all everywhere, in every business scenarios, in every business areas, this data science has came into the picture. That's why we can find out a lot of jobs as a data scientist and the machine learning engineers. So this is about a basic introduction about the data science. So starting from collecting the data and up to developing a predictive model, that is a real data scientist or a machine learning engineer. It contains various stages like data handling, data cleansing, data analytics, data visualization, and the predictive modeling. These are the 6 different types of stages what we are going to use as part of the machine learning or the data science projects. Now we are going to discuss about what are the various technologies that we are going to use in a data science. So the same thing already have discussed about that. Data handling is going to be done by big data, data cleansing, machine learning, data visualization, and one more is there, that is nothing but what we call it as web scraping. Sometimes it is required to extract the data from websites. For example, let us say some event has been got occurred. For example, let us say in year 2017 or 2016, so our Indian government has announced demonetization of the currency of 500 and the 1000 notes. So people has reacted over the Facebook and the people has been reacted over the Twitters. We want to do some sentimental analysis. So how the people has been reacted and how many people has been shown the trust, how many people has been shown the joy, how many people are in the joy mode. We want to do some sentimental analysis. We have to collect the data from the websites. So the technique is what we are going to call it as web scraping. That also we do it practically in our course curriculum. We are going to try to extract the data from the websites, not only websites like Amazon and Flipkart. Even we can do something like a Facebook and the Twitters also. We do it practically and programmatically. We do the web scraping techniques, how to extract the tweets from the Twitters based on a particular word. Let us say something like a demonetization. I want to pick all the tweets which are related to demonetization. So I can pick it and I can do some analysis on that. That is what we call it as sentimental analysis, which we do it in our machine learning algorithms. So the first one is going to be the big data. So big data is nothing but, as you know that, which represents a very huge volumes of data, very high volumes of data, maybe some structured or unstructured data, where our traditional systems and the existing systems cannot handle them. So those type of data sets are what we call it as the big data. We have a various type of big data systems are available. Like we know that one of the most popular big data system is Apache Hadoop. Even the Microsoft has developed the Microsoft Insights, and we have big data in Excel from 2013. And even we are having SAP HANA, Presto, and we are having Amazon Web Services. All these are going to be comes under the concept of the big data technologies. So we are going to discuss about some few points about how the big data technologies are going to be gets working. And after that, we are having a data cleansing. Already we discussed about that. It's a process of detecting and correcting or removing of corrupt and inaccurate data from a record set and refers to in identifying the incomplete and inaccurate data set is going to be. It's simply nothing but some data cleansing. How to do the data cleansing? We have a various technologies are available. Most of the data cleansing is implemented by using Excel itself. Excel is a very powerful a data cleansing tool. We can use it. Data cleansing, even we use the R, we are going to use Python. Apart from that, even there are some ETL tools are available, like open source ETL tools, like we have a talent. Even some tools like we have some online tools are available, like WinPure, etc. is going to be gets available. These are the data cleansing tools what we are going to use it. And apart from that, so it is a data cleansing cycle. So what data you want to analyze? So remove the duplicate data, standardize the data, normalize the data, check the quality of the data. And again, it's going to be given for analysis. If you can't do a proper analysis, again, the cycle is going to be gets repeated. This is what we generally call it as a data cleansing techniques we are going to call it as. And the next one is going to be the web scraping. As already discussed, it is a process of extracting the data from the websites and storing in our local systems, either in a CSV formats or a database formats. We have a lot of online tools are available. There are so many online tools are available. Open source tools are available. Like we are having something like I'm going to use a tool called as import.io. There is a tool called as import.io. It is one of the most popular and so free to use, which is going to be an online tool for performing the data web scraping. Just you can give the website name, automatically all the data is going to be imported. For example, let us say that I have some Amazon website. You can go to the Amazon. From the Amazon, for example, I want to pick the prices of the laptops. The laptops prices I want to find it off. So simply what we can do is you can get registered with the you can register with that whatever the website I have told you, import.io. Just copy this particular URL and directly go there, register yourself first of all. And after that, what we can do is simply if you simply give that particular website, automatically the web scraping is going to be gets done automatically by itself. It is going to be done automatically by itself. You can just sign in actually, register with that and give the URL, automatically it is going to be done. So which we see it practically. Not only the import.io, we are having a different kinds of tools are there. Like even we are having the web house. We are going to have a webhost.io. It is also one of the data extraction tool, which we can call it as a web scraping tools it is going to be. So use it for free. You can just use it for free. You can get registered yourself and just give the website name. Automatically, it can extract the data and puts the data into in the Excel formats and the CSV formats, whatever the data you got to require it here. So that is what we are going to do as part of this particular application. So next, apart from that particular web scraping, we are going to use something called as data visualization. So import.io, webhost.exe, scraping, and visual scrapper, all these are some of the web scraping tools are available. So this is a simple presentation to understand it. From the websites, we are going to extract the data and we are going to put it into the Excel sheets, or it may be CSV or any database formats. Next one is data visualization. You can understand it. Normally, when you see the data, some patterns and some trends cannot be visible to our normal eye. So the correlations, patterns, and trends, they can be easily understandable with the data visualization. We have a lot of data visualization tools are there. There are so many commercial and open source products are there. Tableau, ClickView, we are having Vika, Excel, R, Google Charts. There are so many tools are available. And apart from that, this is data visualization. As you know that these are histograms, scatter plots. We can do the visualization in the various formats. We can do that. And the main important is going to be the machine learning. So learning is something similar to the human learning. I'll make a little bit more about the machine learning in the coming classes. I'm just giving an overview about the machine learning right now. We are giving the ability to the computer to learn by itself without having any explicit coding. We are not going to give any code. We only just specify the algorithm, which algorithm it has to be gets used. That particular algorithm is going to be gets used. So to make some predictive analysis by the machine itself. And this machine learning is a terminology which was developed by a person called as an Arthur Samuel. And around in 1960s only, we have this machine learning concepts. He was an employee of the IBM, and he was the pioneer at the time in gaming and the artificial intelligence. So while he was working in IBM, he developed this terminology called as the machine learning. So what are the machine learning softwares are available? We have a lot of languages are there. R is one of the most popular, R and the Python. These are the most languages. TensorFlow, MATLAB, Splunk, Amazon Machine Learning. These are all the different kinds of the languages what we can use. You can just go to the Google and just once you type it. So what are the top machine learning languages? Top machine learning languages. So in that, the first two places is going to be the R and the Python is going to be the most popular languages which we are going to use here. So these are the some of the most popular languages, top 8 languages for the machine learning. We can see that in that it is going to be Python and the R. Even by using Java, C, C++ also we can do that, but you should be a little bit expertise in those particular languages. But whereas in R and the Python, there are not that much they are not going to be that much languages. And Python, we are going to use Pandas, NumPy, sklearn. These are all the different type of packages what we are going to use it in the part of the Python languages. So these are the languages. You can see Python is one of the most popular R. So R and the Python almost are plays the same important role in the real applications. And this training is completely by using R and the Python itself. You can work with both of them. We are going to work with the both of them. We are going to work with that by using R and by using the Python also, we are going to work with that. So to understand exactly what is a machine learning, so we can just see this particular picture. You can understand a clear idea about that. Over the time period, how the accuracy has been gets increased. So in the place of that particular prediction concept, over the time period, you can see earlier how the prediction used to be gets done. Depending on the last month and depending on the last year demand, we used to do the predictions. But in that cases, 40% accuracy and 60% is an error ratio. But over the time period, if you can see, the man has been got replaced by the, it's a machine. So 90% is an efficiency, that is an accuracy has came. But still we are having 10% error ratio is going to be gets available. So this picture is going to make you understand what is exactly the machine learning. Statistical predictive analysis, in that 30% is going to be the error ratio and 70% is the accuracy. And by using various latest technologies and the latest softwares, so this particular machine learning has came and it has been improved the performance up to the 90% of accuracy and 10% is going to be the error ratio it is going to be. So this is about the just a basic introduction to the data science. So as part of our course curriculum, we are going to use the languages like R, Python, we are going to use. And as you know that this is a free course. So as part of our current basic free course curriculum, we are going to just give you a training on the basics of the data science. So as we have already discussed, we'll discuss about the need of a data science and role of a data scientist. And we are going to learn a basics part of the R to learn. This is a course curriculum for the free course. It's not for the actual course, it's for the free course actually. So we are going to give a 20 days training for this particular free course, where we are going to be getting some knowledge with the R, working with the packages, what are the functions that are available in R, how to load the data in the R, and all these things, plottings, a little bit idea about the plottings, and introduction to the machine learning. And here, as part of the free course, you are going to get two algorithms. We are going to get it here. Two projects we are going to do. So two trainings, practically, we are going to do that. One is a market basket analysis. In a grocery stores, we know that how frequently, what type of combinations the people are buying. Even in e-commerce sites also, what are the combination of the products that we can identify with the help of the market basket analysis, we are going to do that. And even we are going to use an algorithm called as a KNN algorithms, and where we are going to diagnose the cancer cells. We are going to predict what kind of cells are going to be the cancer cells, and which kind of cancer cells are going to be the non-cancer cells. So that kind of diagnosis, we are going to do it practically as part of this particular free course training period. This is only just an introduction class. In the next class, I will make it a more and more clear about the machine learning. And after that, we'll start with our practical oriented. So this is about some introduction class. This is only for the introduction part. So basically for data, starting from the data handling, data cleansing, data analytics, data visualization, and machine learning. These are the basic stages and what are the techniques which we have to learn. When you go to a data science project, you may be working in the data visualization, or you may be working in the data analytics part, or you may be working in the handling of the data, or you may be working in the machine learning. Machine learning is the most important part of this data science course curriculum. So in these 20 days or 3 weeks of training, you will be getting some introduction to what is a machine learning. And there is another course curriculum is there where we will be where we are going to train it with all the complete machine learning algorithms. It's a free training course for 3 weeks of the timing it is going to be. Okay. So this is for the today's introduction class. So in the next class, we'll make it more and more clear. So if you have any questions, so we can just type it in the chat panels. I can just answer them. Anyone, any questions from your side?